is John Andrews, Social and Digital Media Manager for Redport Information Assurance. Today our screencast is going to be about the safest internet browsers, basically highlighting on the key question that a lot of people are mainly concerned with on is my internet browser safe enough and which one you are using specifically. The content, however, on what we are going to be covering today is first, what this presentation is about and answering the question, is the browser you're using safe enough? Before leading into the next bullet on which one is best, and that is where we will specifically review the top four most popular browsers used by users today, starting with Internet Explorer, mostly used by Microsoft users, Mozilla and Google Chrome, which are two open source internet browsers, which I will talk about more in a minute. Before leading into our last browser, which is Safari, a pre-installed browser on all Apple Mac computers. All of the browsers we are covering, though, are only being reviewed by a security standpoint, because a lot of people always look into performance and wonder if the browser they are using will speed up their computer. No, forget speed. The internet browser will not determine whether or not your computer runs faster or the internet pages you browse load up quicker. That is all on a different aspect of computing that we aren't covering today. Quit worrying about how cool the browser looks, how fast it is, how many features it has, and start worrying about more on the browser security background. Now, I'm going to be taking the top four browsers by popular demand, starting with Internet Explorer. Internet Explorer is the browser that about 90% of all users use currently. But because of all the current updates that the Windows operating system puts out, I'd say that Internet Explorer is the most patched browser there is, meaning developers have tried taking all of the vulnerabilities that Internet Explorer had in the past and updates the security miscues within the browser itself so it runs better with each update it has. But because 90% use Internet Explorer, this makes the particular browser a very large target for hackers, and in today's industry, that's, you know, what they are looking for. And people are more prone to clicking on things that they really aren't aware of clicking on, especially newcomers and beginners starting to use the computer for the first time. But to prevent all of these attacks from happening due to Microsoft's unstable versions of Internet Explorer, I would suggest switching to a more stable browser as an alternative, and that leads us right into Mozilla Firefox. Mozilla, compared to Internet Explorer, is the most user-friendly browser of the bunch. It offers more flexibility, navigation, and possesses more features such as add-ons, which are tweaks that supplement and aid in the overall security of the browser itself. It also lets you do more things that Internet Explorer generally won't allow you to do. Adware prevention is something that Mozilla seems to manage very well, but still has room for improvement. Although, yes, the add-on feature called AdBlock will probably eliminate some, if not all, of the pop-ups you may encounter, but a few might be able to sneak onto your desktop running behind your browser window if you're not careful. Mozilla, to me, is a better alternative versus that of Internet Explorer based off of the security, which peaked in 2010, excuse me. Now, this leads us to Google Chrome. Google Chrome, personally, is the best one out of all four of these that I'm going to be reviewing, not just based on security, but on overall operation, functionality, performance, design, all of the above. Originally, Chrome was introduced in 2008, where it was solely a Microsoft program, but then they implemented this open source type of programming, which they took or inherited some of the components from Mozilla and Safari that I'm going to be introducing next. But it has the security and features of Mozilla and also offers the sleek design and operation of that of Safari. But with Google Chrome not getting much recognition in the last couple years due to the popularity of Internet Explorer and Mozilla, this makes Google Chrome users less of a threat to hackers out there. Safari, next, is the least popular amongst the four. Not too many people in the past generations know about this unless they operated on a Mac product or Mac operating system. But in my generation today, Safari is probably the most well-known due to widespread popularity of Apple products out there. But, you know, Safari began as a Mac-only browser in 2003, but it was finally released to Microsoft users around the June 2007 mark or so. 1% of all internet users, mainly from Microsoft operating systems, use Safari, making it the least popular browser of the four mentioned. However, operating Safari on a Windows system is a lot more different than operating on a Mac. The Apple security support for Windows hasn't been consistent with the patches with the browser or anything of that matter when updating on a Windows. But since Safari is the main pre-installed browser on a Mac, security support is often taken care of in a lot more stable of a platform to operate on. So that is what covers the troubles on operating on the Safari. But now going on, some tips to use on how to gain some security background on your browser regardless of what you use is: 1, if you change any of the security features within the browser you choose, you may be more prone to attacks. So just make sure that if you change anything, just to monitor which ones you change, and if something happens, change it back. 2, make sure you keep your browser up to date, because as more and more security flaws are reported, you know, the sooner that browser may have an update to patch those fixes. So just be on the lookout. And 3, just make sure to be safe. Keep your software firewalls turned on, which is explained more in detail in my How to Protect Your Mac screencast. But the firewall on any type of operating system, whether Windows or Mac, aids in the permissions of certain types of software from the internet trying to access your computer. Most of you guys see this come up when, you know, trying to download or pre-install something on your computer, and a small screen pops up and asks you either if you want to allow it to download, or it allows you to type in a password that you originally set on your computer. But this is my review on the top 4 browsers and the securities they offer. But really, ultimately, it is up to you on which one you use, but just be safe. And with that being said, check out our website at www.redport-ia.com, which offers quality information assurance and computer security. And also, check out our Facebook page and like us at facebook.com/redport, and also follow us on Twitter at redport_IA. Thank you. I'm John Andrews, and everybody have a nice day.